Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the 1's and the 2's complement representation of the binary numbers. So this 1's and the 2's complement, and particularly this 2's complement, is the most common method of representing the signed binary numbers in the digital circuits. Now so far in our discussion, we only dealt with the unsigned binary numbers. So these unsigned binary numbers are only positive numbers, and therefore such numbers can be represented without any sign convention. But using these signed binary numbers, we can represent both positive as well as the negative numbers. So in a decimal number system, the positive and the negative numbers are represented using the plus or the minus sign. But in binary number system, since we are dealing with only ones and zeros, so the negative numbers are represented in a different way. So there are three different ways to represent this signed binary number, that is signed magnitude form, 1's complement and the 2's complement. So one by one, we will see all three different types of representations. And to understand them more clearly, let us briefly talk about the unsigned binary numbers. So as I said earlier, using this unsigned binary number representation, we can represent only positive numbers. So if we have an n bit of unsigned binary number, then all n bits are used for representing the magnitude or the value of that binary number. For example, if we represent 16 in the unsigned binary number, then all 5 bits are used for representing the magnitude of that number. So in this unsigned binary number representation, using the n bits, the range of numbers which we can represent are from 0 to 2 to the power n minus 1. For example, using 4 bits, we can represent the numbers starting from 0 to 15. On the other end, with the signed binary numbers, we can represent both positive as well as the negative numbers. So in these signed binary numbers, the most significant bit or the MSB is the sign bit. So if we have a n bit of signed binary number, then the MSB is the sign bit, and the remaining n minus 1 bit represents the magnitude of that number. For example, in the 8 bit signed binary number, this MSB is the sign bit and the remaining bits represents the magnitude. So depending on the value of the sign bit, we can decide whether the number is positive or negative. So as I said earlier, there are three different ways to represent this signed binary number, that is signed magnitude form, 1's complement and the 2's complement. So in all three forms, the representation of the positive number is same. So for the positive number, the sign bit or the MSB is equal to 0, while for the negative number, the sign bit is equal to 1. Now although for the negative numbers, this MSB or the sign bit is 1 in all these three forms, but if you see the actual number representation, then it is different in all these three forms. That means suppose if we represent the same negative number in the signed magnitude form or in 1's complement and the 2's complement form, then their actual representation is different in all three forms. So one by one, we will see that how to represent the negative number in all these three forms. And first, let us start with the signed magnitude form. So this signed magnitude form representation is pretty straightforward. So for positive numbers, the MSB or the sign bit is 0, while for the negative number, this MSB or the sign bit is 1. And the magnitude of the number is represented in the true binary form. For example, if we represent this plus 34 in a 8-bit signed magnitude form, then its magnitude is represented in a true binary form, while a 0 is put at the MSB. On the other end, for the minus 34, instead of 0, there is a 1 in the sign bit. But if you see the magnitude representation, then it remains the same. So let's take one more example. So if we represent the plus 52 in a 8-bit signed magnitude form, then the MSB is equal to 0, and in the remaining 7 bits, the magnitude of the number is represented in the true binary form. That is equal to 0110100. On the other end, if we represent the minus 52 in this signed magnitude form, then this MSB or the sign bit is equal to 1. And if you see the magnitude bits, then it remains the same. So that is how we can represent any signed binary number in this signed magnitude form. but there is a special case of representing the zero in the sine magnitude form. So in a sine magnitude form, there are two different representations of the zero. So in this sine magnitude form, using the n bits, the range of numbers which can be represented are from minus 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1. For example, using the 4 bits, the range of number which can be represented are from minus 7 to plus 7. That means there are 7 negative numbers, 7 positive numbers, and 2 different representations of the 0. Now, although the representation of the sine number is pretty straightforward in the sine magnitude form, but if we perform the arithmetic operation in this particular form, then it requires a great deal of manipulation. Moreover, there are two different representations of zero, and therefore the use of the sine magnitude form in the digital circuits and the computer is a bit impractical. Alright, so now let's see the 1's complement representation. So as I said earlier, in this 1's complement form, the representation of the positive number is same as the sine magnitude form. That means the magnitude of the number is represented in the true binary form, and for the positive number, this MSB is equal to 0. But the representation of the negative number is a bit different. So to represent the negative number in a 1's complement form, first of all, just write the equivalent positive number. So in this case, suppose if we want to represent the minus 34 in a 1's complement form, then first of all, let us write the equivalent positive number. And now, in that number, just invert the zeros with the 1 and 1's with the 0. And in this inversion, also include the sine bit. So this represents the minus 34 in a 1's complement form. And in fact, it is called the 1's complement of the plus 34. That means just by inverting the 1's with the zeros and zeros with the 1 in the positive number, we can find the 1's complement of that particular number. So let us understand how it works. So mathematically, for some n bit number n, its 1's complement is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1 minus n. So for example, let us take one number 12. So if we represent it in a 5 bit form, then it is equal to 01100, and its 1's complement is equal to 2 to the power 5 minus 1 minus 12. So in a binary form, this is how it can be represented. So if we subtract this 12 from the 31, then we will get 10011. That means the 1's complement of this 12 is equal to 10011. So as you can see, whenever we subtract a number from all 1's, then 0 in that number will get replaced by the 1, while the 1 in that number gets replaced by the 0. That means in the given number, if we replace all the 0's by 1 and 1's by 0, then we can directly find the 1's complement of that given number. So as we have seen, the 1's complement of the positive number is equal to negative number. So after the 1's complement, this 0 in the MSB gets replaced by the 1, which indicates that after the complement, the number is negative. And if we once again take the 1's complement of this number, then once again we will get the original number. That means in this number, if we replace all the 1's by 0 and 0's by 1, then once again we will get our original number. So that is how we can perform the 1's complement of the given number. So using n bits, the range of number which can be represented in this 1's complement form are from minus 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1. For example, using 4 bits, we can represent the number starting from minus 7 to plus 7. And here is the list of all numbers which can be represented in a 1's complement form using 4 bits. So here, as you can see, similar to the sine magnitude form, there are two different representations for 0. Now from the digital hardware perspective, finding the 1's complement of the number is very easy, because simply we need to replace all 1's by 0's and 0's by the 1 in the particular number, right? So even using simple NOT gate, we can find the complement of the given number. But the only disadvantage of this 1's complement form is that there are two different representations for the 0. So that is all about the 1's complement. Similarly, now let us see the 2's complement representation. So in the 2's complement form, the representation of the positive number is same as the 1's complement and the sine magnitude form. That means for the positive number, the MSB or the sine bit is 0 and the magnitude is represented in a true binary form. And if we find the 2's complement of that positive number, then we will get the equivalent negative number in the 2's complement form. For example, if we find the 2's complement of this plus 34, then we will get the minus 34. Or to be precise, we will get the 2's complement representation of this minus 34. So there are a couple of ways for finding this 2's complement. So if you want to represent the minus 34 in a 2's complement form, then first of all, write down the number corresponding to plus 34. So in the 8-bit form, it is equal to 001000010. Now starting from the least significant bit or the LSB, copy all the bits until you encounter the first one. That means copy all the bits up to first one. And then after, replace all zeros by 1 and 1s by 0 including the sign bit. So after the first one, all the zeros have been replaced by the 1 and 1s have been replaced by the 0. So this representation is a minus 34 in the 2's complement form. Or in other words, it represents the 2's complement of the number plus 34. So this is a one way of finding the 2's complement of the particular number. The second way is, first take the 1's complement of that number and then add 1 to that 1's complement. So the resultant is a 2's complement of that particular number. So as you have seen earlier, for finding the 1's complement, we need to replace all the zeros by 1 and 1s by 0 in that particular number. And then after, if we just add 1 to that 1's complement, then we will get the 2's complement of that particular number. So in this case, by this method, we will find the 2's complement of the number plus 34. So this is the second way of finding the 2's complement of that particular number. And the third one is the traditional way. So mathematically, if we have some n bit number n, then its 2's complement is equal to 2 to the power n minus n. So once again, let us take the number 34. And this is how it can be represented in a 8-bit form. So its 2's complement is equal to 2 to the power 8 minus 34. Or in a binary form, it is the subtraction of the number 256 and 34. So if we do the subtraction, then we will get a number that is 1100100, which is the 2's complement of the number plus 34. So this is the another way of finding the 2's complement. Now here, this 2 to the power n minus n can also be written as 2 to the power n minus 1 minus n plus 1. So here if you observe, then this 2 to the power n minus 1 minus n is actually a 1's complement of the number n. Therefore, if we just take the 1's complement of the number n and if we just add 1 to it, then we will get the 2's complement of the number n. So to find the 2's complement of the number, you can follow any of the three methods. But the first one, which I have discussed earlier, is more convenient for the hand calculations. Alright, so now let us take one more example. So let's say, we want to represent this minus 60 in the 2's complement form. So first, let us write down the number corresponding to plus 60. That is equal to 001111100. Now to find the 2's complement of that number, starting from the LSB, just copy all the bits until you encounter the first one. And once you encounter the 1, then after that, replace all the zeros by the 1 and 1s by the 0 in that particular number. So this is the representation of the minus 60 in the 2's complement form. So in this way, we can find the 2's complement of the given number. Now using the n bits, the range of the number which can be represented in this 2's complement form are from minus 2 to the power n minus 1 to 2 to the power n minus 1 minus 1. For example, using the 4 bits, we can represent the numbers starting from minus 8 to plus 7. So here is the list of all the numbers which can be represented using the 4 bits in the 2's complement form. So using the 4 bits, we can represent 7 positive numbers and 8 negative numbers. And in this 2's complement form, there is only a unique way of representing this 0. So if we take the 2's complement of this number plus 3, then we will get the minus 3. Likewise, if we take the 2's complement of the negative number, for example a minus 5, then we will get the positive number. But if we try to find the 2's complement of the most negative number, then we will get the same number. For example, here if we try to find the 2's complement of the number minus 8, then we will get the same number. The reason is that in this 2's complement form, we can represent one more negative number than the positive number. So if we try to find the 2's complement of this most negative number, then there is no corresponding positive number in this representation. That means if we try to find the 2's complement of this most negative number, then we will get the same number. So that is one more thing which we need to keep in mind while performing the 2's complement. So as I said, these 1's and the 2's complement, and specifically this 2's complement, is very useful in performing the arithmetic operations. Because with the 2's complement representation, without using the subtraction circuit, it is possible to perform the subtraction only using the adder circuit. So in the next video, we will see that how to perform the binary addition and the subtraction using this 1's complement and the 2's complement. But I hope in this video, you understood the different ways of representing the signed binary numbers. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.